जब कोई लिखन खरीदो
Mezeport Act bill has affected us very much because this could be the privatization totally, as our senior leaders said also, President of All India Port and Dock Workers Federation, Hanif ji and others. We port employees at the moment are struggling for the business. The port is deficit for 86 crores at the moment, and we have around 1,300 employees, the serving employees, and 4,500 pensioners. Around 5,000 pensioners are depending, families are depending on the pension. As our comrade said, but number 10 and 11, if they privatize, everything will go and no work will be there for the workmen. I also say, as our comrade said, the port is to handle all type of cargoes. You all know very well, as Patrakar, in Goa, we always have allegations on the port for handling different type of cargoes. Port is here to handle all type of cargoes. Also, this strike notice which has been served will be serving all the ports, will be serving before 30th, and will be definitely going countrywide for the strike for these demands of us. And employees who really have to go through phases because of, especially also, they are trying to have the secret ballot for nominating the trustees on the board. At the moment, we have the check-off system. Two board representatives are there, the labor trustees, but if they make it for the secret ballot, then all involvement of the local politicians, all involvements of money power, everything will come. So that privilege has to be retained to keep the check-off system, not the secret ballot. This is what I'd like to submit on behalf of our Marmanga Port and Railway Workers Union.
I just wanted to highlight, as on a bill sir ke paas aunkna, but amche management and they have taken a decision to privatize berth number 10 and 11. हमको डिसीजन देना सड़ा पार्टी ऑलरेडी इंटरनली दे हैव प्रिपेयर्ड द पार्टी दे हैव स्पोकन टू द पार्टी टू विच पार्टी दे आर गोइंग टू टेक बट आफ्टर आवर बोर्ड मेंबर हाईलाइटेड इस इन द बोर्ड मीटिंग देन दे हैड अ मीटिंग विद द यूनिट्स बट स्टिल इंटरनली एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग ऑन टू प्राइवेटाइज द
बोर्ड व्हाट इज द बोर्ड लाइकली टू हैंडल कितने कार्गो हैंडल कर पाता है
बोर्ड सी इफ इट इज गिवन टू प्राइवेट पार्टी It is not mentioned, or they will handle any this cargo. Okay. So whichever cargo we were handling, they will handle it. And our staff will be surplus, and they will treat a surplus and force us to go take VRS.
I'd like to state that first of all, berth number 9, which is lying idle under the pretext of monetization, the decision already has been taken to privatize and float the tender. Secondly, right now, out of the level berth, four employees are being utilized only at two berths, that is berth number 10 and 11. If these two berths are handed over to the private companies, the existing employees which are working right now, 1,300 and odd, and stewards and other stakeholders, they will completely lose their employment, which is bad for the port as well as for the economy, because they are trying to completely wipe out the employment in the organized sector, which is requirement of the present stage. Moreover, if you see, due to the intervention of the ministry earlier on the cruise terminal, for example, I'm telling you, we used to generate around 70 lakhs one vessel with the old rates. Subsequently, in the year 2017, after rationalization of levies, we could collect only $0.35 per JRT, where we lost around 50 lakhs per vessel revenue. And now, again, they have brought one more changes, that $0.085 per JRT, where we are getting only 4 to 5 lakhs. Actually, port is not even recovering the cost what we are spending to berth one vessel, cruise vessel. All this we are doing for the betterment of the state, local economy, which is generating employment like taxi and a small thing. See, we are contributing so much to the local economy. If the private entity comes to the port and do the business, they are not going to do this all these activities which are required for the betterment of states and economy and public at a whole.
1.75 lakh acres of land. By virtue of this new enactment, land mafia will be developed, yes, everything, because we will go to private party land. What we are telling, the land which is required for the future development of the government can be retained. Otherwise, you can identify the land on market value, assess the value on market rate. Now what we are doing, we are taking depreciation value. Because once there, the intention by India is to convert this as companies, they can adopt a resolution with the four people in the board, authority board, to convert this port as a company. Once it is becoming a company, it is quite natural, automatically it will be privatized. If I am taking 51% of the share of that particular company, I am the boss. If I am having 74 and 26%, only one director will be there, rest will be managed by me. So we fear that the intention, hidden agenda behind this authority act enactment is to convert the force as companies, government force as companies, and hand it over to private parties.